Hi, this is Kelly Neal again, and today we're going to start looking at atrial rhythms and our PACs. So sometimes, for one reason or another, the sinus node loses its pacemaking capability, and the function is taken over along another site of the conduction system. We have to remember that whatever's the fastest has the fastest rate, that's what's going to pace the heart. Normally, that should be the SA node at a rate of 60 to 100, but if there's anything that's irritated in the atria, it can take over. Atrial rhythms are caused by the atrial rate becoming faster than the sinus rate. And it says here it can be from irritability or an escape mechanism, but 99% of the time when we're looking at atrial rhythms, it's usually an irritability issue. Impulses that originate from the atria are going to travel down the ventricles normally. The only difference is from sinus rhythms is that the atrial depolarization is going to be a little slower and a little rougher. So what we're saying is the atria are still going to depolarize, so we'll still see something there for our P wave. But because it's not coming from the sinus node through the normal pathways, instead of getting that nice normal rounded sinus P wave, our P wave is going to be atypical. It may be notched, it can be flattened, it can be sawtooth, but it's going to be different than what that normal nice looking sinus P wave that we've gotten used to is going to be. There are a few features in common with atrial rhythms. They originate from above the ventricles. They're supraventricular in origin, meaning they come down the ventricular pathways normally. And you know something comes down the pathways normally when you have a normal size QRS. When you have a normal size QRS that is 0.12, or I'm sorry, less than 0.12, you know it had to come through the pathways through the normal conduction route. Now, it is possible to have underlying bundle branch blocks along with an atrial rhythm. So if you had a sinus rhythm with a bundle branch block and now all of a sudden you have an atrial rhythm, you could have that same bundle branch block there. The biggest thing with the atrial rhythms is we're going to have an abnormal P wave. So we'll start looking at our PACs. And when we look at the PACs, so when we start looking at these PACs, a PAC is a premature atrial contraction. It's an irritable focus in the atrium that fires early and it produces a single ectopic beat. Ectopic means just coming outside the normal focus. It is a single beat, not a rhythm. So we're still going to have to determine the underlying rhythm. We would have a sinus rhythm with a PAC or a sinus brady with a PAC. Because it fires early, it is going to make the underlying rhythm irregular, but you still need to determine the underlying rhythm. So if I look at this rhythm here, I can see here that it from P to P looks normal, and then this beat here came early. So for the spacing from this beat to this beat is early, and then you can see it lengthens out between this beat. So this is going to make this an irregular rhythm. My rate in 3 seconds, it looks like I have 1, 2, 3, 4. So my rate would be 80. So what I want to look at is my whole R to R irregular? Kind of like when we looked at sinus arrhythmias and we saw things that speeded up and slowed down. Is that what we have here? Or is this just a distinct beat that's coming in early? So it looks like this beat to this beat, I've got a P wave that looks normal and rounded. Looks like I have a normal PR interval, a QRS interval that looks okay, and a QT interval that looks okay. And then this beat looks exactly like that. And then this one here comes early. I can tell that it's firing early, it's premature. My P wave is going upside down. Now, not all PACs have to be upside down. They can be up, they can be down, they can be spiked, they can be flattened. But it does come early. This particular one goes upside down. But another really big distinction to make is that my PR interval is still a normal measurement. In future classes, when we start learning about things that come from the junction, we'll find that we can get upside down P waves with that as well, but our PR interval would shorten. This one here, I have an upside down P wave, but I have a normal PR interval. You'll also notice that this QRS complex does not change in its configuration. And so this is going to make this a premature atrial contraction. Now, another distinction that you're going to see with PACs is what we call a compensatory pause. It's a time lag that happens after the premature beat. And so what happens with a PAC is your sinus node waits. So if the sinus node should, from here to here is where the sinus node fired, it should have fired about here. Only we had this beat that came in early. So what the sinus node does is it waits from where it should have fired to fire again. So that gives you a little time lag called a compensatory pause. That is not an absolute in this complex, but it does frequently happen. So if we go to our next slide, here's another example of a PAC. I can see here that my spacing here from R to R looks regular, and then this one here came in early, and then this one here is delayed a little bit longer. Because again, with these compensatory pauses, if my QRS complex should have landed here, it waits from here to fire again. So I don't look at this and say I have a premature atrial beat plus a pause. That pause is part of the premature beat. So what I look at here is I look at these regular beats. They look normal, and these two over here look normal. My rate here is only 50, but I can see that on these other, on the beats that came, that are normally spaced, it looks like I have a nice normal rounded sinus P wave. Looks like my PR interval is normal. My QRS complex looks normal size. And my QT interval looks normal. So it looks like it's sinus in origin, but my rate's only 50, so it would be a sinus bradycardia. Now this beat came early. It's premature. Again, on this particular example, the P wave goes upside down. It's inverted. It doesn't have to. It just happens to be in this particular case. But my PR interval is a normal measurement. My QRS doesn't change. My QT interval doesn't change. So this is going to make this a PAC, a premature atrial contraction. Now, again, I have this little time lag after it. Not an absolute, but a really common thing to see. And so I would document this sinus bradycardia at 50 with one PAC. Now, this example down here below, I can tell that my spacing here from here to here, then I've got a shorter beat. This beat here comes in early. It's premature. Has a little time lag after it, and then I go back to a normal spacing, and then this beat here comes in early. So it looks like I have this beat here is premature, and this beat here is premature. So, and it looks like something else is going on over here, which we'll talk about that in a little while. So on these particular cases, my regularly spaced beats, they look like they're normally spaced. They look like they have a sinus P wave for each and every beat. PR interval looks like it's okay. QRS looks okay, and QT looks okay. So it looks like I'm in a sinus rhythm, but I have these beats that are firing early. So look at what my T wave normally looks like here, and then look at the T wave here. And you can see it looks like the P and the T of this beat have blended together to become some new looking waveform. So this beat fires early. I think there's still a P wave with it because it looks so different than the T wave. This doesn't look anything like this one. So it looks like I've got a P and a T blended together. QRS size is normal, and I have a little time lag. So it looks like a PAC. And then this one here looks like the exact same thing. So I would chart this sinus rhythm with two PACs. Now, this one here, this top beat here, I've got a regular spacing from this beat to the third beat looks regular. And then the fourth beat comes in early. It is premature, has a little time lag after it. And then I go back to my normal spacing again. So I look at the normal stuff first. It's regularly spaced, has a P wave for each and every QRS. Right here in this first 3 seconds, I've got a rate of 60. PR interval, QRS, and QT look like they're okay, so it looks like I'm a sinus rhythm. But then I have this beat that fires early. It's premature, has a P wave. Again, this one goes upside down. PR interval is a normal measurement. QRS doesn't really change, so it looks like I have a PAC, a premature atrial contraction, as I have that time lag after it again. So I would chart this sinus rhythm at 60 with one PAC. Now on this example down here, we see that our spacing looks good until I get to this fifth beat, it comes in early. So this one fires early here, and then it goes back to my normal spacing. So on my normal beats, regularly spaced, I have a P wave for each and every QRS. PR interval looks okay. QRS looks okay. It looks like right here my rate would have been 80. So it looks like I'm a sinus rhythm at 80. Now I have this beat that fires early. It's premature. This one here, you can see my P wave. It doesn't look like any of my others. It looks nice and tall and kind of spiked looking. Normal PR interval measurement though. QRS doesn't change. Little time lag after it. So this would be a sinus rhythm at 80 with one PAC. Looks like I would have had another one right over here if my strip had been a little bit longer. Now, when you're looking at is something a PAC versus a sinus arrhythmia, because sinus arrhythmia, as we said, they can speed up, slow down. That's going to make them look irregular. One of the things you're going to notice is with a PAC, R to R to R is regular. And then I have this beat that fires early. This beat that comes early, you're going to notice a different configuration of the P wave. This one goes half up, half down. It's biphasic. PR interval is still normal, and usually you have a little time lag after it, and then it'll go right back to its normal spacing. Where this one here is a sinus arrhythmia, my R to R to R speeds up and slows down, but you'll notice that my P wave does not change for any of these. I have that nice normal sinus P wave for each and every complex throughout the entire strip. It just tends to speed up and slow down with the respiratory cycle. Now, PACs are generally caused by heart disease, hyperthyroid disease, pulmonary disease, it's very common in, hypoxia, excessive caffeine intake. The significance is going to depend on its frequency. They do not usually require any treatment. They really do not impact the cardiac output. But if you do have them really frequently, it is telling you that you're having irritation happen to the atria, and that could potentially progress on to an atrial flutter or an atrial fib. So in that respect, it is something that they may want to pay attention to, but the PACs by themselves do not change your cardiac output. If they do decide to treat it just because they're afraid it'll go into a worse atrial rhythm, they might try something like digoxin or your beta blockers or your calcium channel blockers and possibly even procainamide. So thank you for listening to PACs.